Hi, crafters. It's Karen, and I have a design team project for Diamond Dyes. I created a couple of snow globes. I was inspired by this particular punch from Fiskars, and I picked this up at Joann's a little while back. And look how cute. This is what the punch looks like punched out. Really super cute. So this tiny piece is the little base. This is your globe. And then here's a little tree to put inside your globe. Really cute, makes really sweet embellishments for your projects, right? So I was inspired by this to create a Christmas globe. And the dyes I used are, of course, the snowman die set. This is a lot of fun to play with. I love this die. I used the Christmas tree in one of my globes. This is the larger Christmas tree. I used one of the circles, the 5-inch circle from the Nesting Circles die set. And this is such an excellent value. I think there's 20 dies here. But I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah. So at any rate, I used the 5-inch die, the 5-inch circle die here. And then for my base, I used the large mason jar. And I just used the top portion, and it came out really cute. I'll show you. And I also used, I used the bow die, the Diamond Dyes bow die. I used the medium-sized bow. This bow set comes in three different sizes, large, medium, and then there's a really little bow. Hope I'm not making you crazy. There's a little bow. So those are the dies that I created, and that I used, and this is my first attempt at the snow globe. So in itself it's cute, except you can't see into the snow globe because I used vellum. But basically what I did was I cut my mason jar, and I just used the top portion here, as you can see, and then I painted it so that it would look, like a piece of wood. And then I took my 5-inch circle from the Nesting Circles die, and I used cardstock, the heavyweight cardstock, and I adhered one of the circles back here on the back side of my base. And then I adhered my snowman. And there's also some, but you can't see them. I used some Diamond Dyes snowflakes in there. You can't see them. There's glitter in here. You can't see that. Too bad, because that snowman came out really cute. But anyway, they're all inside that globe. And then I took my vellum and I cut it the same size, and I adhered it with glossy accents all around the edge. And then I adhered the vellum on the outside, or the front side of my base, as you could see there. And then I added my little bow, and I have twine on the middle, just for the touch of it. And that was my little snow globe. But I was disappointed because you can't see through it. So I gave it another go. And this time I used this acetate that I had found at Hobby Lobby. And it's just, see, some of their acetate is printed, but then you can also find the clear acetate. You see there's the sheet there. And it's really nice because your dyes will cut through this. I mean, it's not so stiff that it stresses your dyes. But at any rate, I used this. And I used some of this cording from Hobby Lobby to around my globe. I used that. And here is my second try at my snow globe. And I think this one came out so much better because you could see into my globe. So I put this one together in the same way I did the first one. I cut my base with the mason jar, and then I painted it and inked it, and I gave it a red tint because I wanted it to be that red wood what is that, mahogany, where the wood has a reddish tint to it. You know, I wanted that to be the base. So I did that. And then I took my my first circle, which was on the cardstock, the 110-pound cardstock, and I adhered it to the back, and then I backed it with this piece of pattern paper from My Mind's Eye, just to finish the back a little. So I adhered that there, and then I went over the front side. I adhered a piece of music sheet paper, because I thought it would give the globe a little bit more dimension rather than leaving it white. So I thought it came out really cute and gave it a little hint of a vintage look to it. So I did that, and then I added my tree, my Christmas tree. I had distressed it with the Tim Holtz Distress Ink a little bit to give it a little bit of dimension. And then I put together my snowman. And as you can see from my snowman, When I cut him out with the white cardstock, I always go over him with the Tim Holtz. It's the lightest blue color. I forgot to bring the pen out, but it's the lightest blue distress marker. It might even be weathered wood. I can't remember. But any light blue distress marker would work. And I watered it down with my water brush, and then I hope it's showing, but I did some shadowing on my snowman, if you could see that, where I just gave it a hint of blue. I defined his belly a little more, defined his head a little more. Just, it gives him so much more dimension, and came out really sweet. And then I added his little scarf and hat, and then I added some glue and put my glitter down so that it would act as snow and around the tree as well. So I thought that came out cute. And then I adhered all around the acetate with glossy accents, and then I trimmed it out with the gold cording from Hobby Lobby. And then I adhered this small doily with my bow on the front, and the sentiment is from the Graphic 45 12 Days of Christmas collection. So I thought it came out really cute. I was really pleased with it. And then I created a little stand just really quick. You know, I just took a strip of paper, cut slits in it, and this way, you know, the globe could stand really cute. Whoops, you can't see that the way the camera is, but yeah, this could sit out if I wanted it to, or I could pop a hole in there and make him be an ornament. So that's my latest design team project. I also wanted to let you know about Dee's current wish list Facebook contest for Diamond Dies. Let me get the details real quick for you. So these are the details for the Facebook contest. I'm going to leave the Facebook Diamond Dies Facebook link in the description box. You will see on the Facebook page a real festive picture of a snowman, and you are to share that photo. Comment below the post and be sure to start your comment with "Dear Santa," and let Dee know which three Diamond Dies is at the top of your wish list, and make sure that you like the Diamond Dies Facebook page. So all the details will be below in the description box. So check it out. Check out Diamond Dies Facebook page for not only for this contest, but also for other inspiring ideas on using your dies. So thanks so much for watching. I hope you all are enjoying the season. I've been very busy, and I will be doing a haul video before too long, just for an update, and I will talk to you all soon. Thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.